Jai Gurudev children, today we are going to learn how to create a stained glass effect using oil pastels. The materials required: half A4 size white paper, a waste cloth, clean your crayons before you use, a pencil to draw, and oil pastels. First we learn how to draw. The design should be simple. Let's get started. In stained glass, the design should be very simple. The design should not have complicated and intricate designs. See, here I'm making just a flower. The beauty of stained glass is that they have a thick black outline, which we are going to do it with oil pastels. Basically, we have two types of glass colors, one is water based and other is solvent based. The water based is what we used for the crafting purpose. Solvent based is used by the interior designers. When you use a solvent based colors, that is called stained glass. Okay, so see, I have finished drawing a small flower and we are going to make the lines. We are now going to utilize the total A4 half size of the paper. Your design should completely be covered. See, I have done with the design. Now to give the effect, what we are going to use is, we are going to first use the dark color and a light color. We are going to apply the color in a scribbling shading pan. This is you all have learned, right? Scribbling technique. See, in this way you are going to color the closed parts. Okay. First, I am going to apply the darker shade, moving my hand in a circular way. That is called the scribbling technique. First, I am going to apply the dark brown using the scribbling technique, so that I will leave some spaces for the other color to occupy. Now the lighter shade. Now this lighter shade will fill all the gaps between. You can apply it with pressure. See, this is how it looks. Now we are going to take orange for the petals. In the same way. Children, look, I have done the petals with orange. Above orange, I have applied yellow. And remaining space, I am filling it with different shades of green. First, I am applying the darker shade below and the lighter shade on the top. Different shades of green. If I am taking dark green as a base color, I am taking the lighter shade of it above it. In this way, you have to completely cover the paper. Children, always clean your crayon before you use it with a waste cloth. That is mandatory, so that you don't spoil your work. Make it a habit of cleaning your crayons before using, especially oil pastels, because it grabs more dust. Children, you are here, you observe. I am not using any other tissue paper, cloth or a hand to smudge the colors. I am using only the oil pastels itself to smudge the both colors. After you are done with your coloring, make sure you don't leave any white spots visible. Fill all the white spots properly. Now we are going to take your black crayon and make a thick outline directly. With the pressure, you are going to make the outline. These thick lines gives you a stained glass effect and enhances the beauty of the work. And it's done. Similarly, you can go with the peacock feather design, which I have done. I'll show you how to draw the peacock feather. Mark the center of your page and make 3 vertical partitions. Now from the center, you're going to join these vertical points with a curve. Now joining these 2 curves, make a circle in the center and a small circle without touching the curves, and make the curves as shown. Now your peacock design is ready. Once you are done with your coloring, keep me posted, children. The same technique I used to color this peacock feather. Thank you, children.